In the light of his glory and praise.
Let's sing, we turn our eyes upon Jesus.
We turn our eyes upon in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will in the light of his glory and praise.
Just do it right now. Turn our eyes upon you, Lord. You've already been here in such a beautiful way tonight. And I would ask, Lord, that you would cause all of our hearts to be one heart, all of these voices here tonight, to be one voice of praise and worship. We've come just to honor you. And I know that your healing is going to flow as we worship you. Bodies are going to be touched. Minds are going to be restored. Because that's just the way you are. Precious anointing is in this house tonight.
Hello, everybody, and once again, welcome to Fresh Fire Prayer Ministry, where we keep the fire of the Holy Spirit burning. Today is the day the Lord has made. We choose to rejoice and be glad in it. We thank God for life. We thank God for breath. We thank God for protection, preservation. We thank God for how far he's brought us. It is of the Lord's mercies. The Bible says that's why we are not consumed, because his compassion towards us faileth not. They are new every morning. Great is his faithfulness towards us. During seasons and times like this, it's just the grace of God that sustains us, that helps us, and enables us to go through the days and come out victoriously. So we owe God our praise and worship. He is great and greatly to be praised. I want you to join me this morning, this afternoon, this evening, wherever you are, to join me to say thank you, Jesus, to worship him, to bless him, to exalt him. Thank him for January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, and this month, and the month ahead. Thanking him even in advance for victory throughout this year. Thanking him for preserving and protecting us from COVID, from death, from accident, from shame, disgrace, from all the evil plans of our enemies that was orchestrated against us, but we've come through all by his grace and mercy, and he who called us will keep on taking care of us. For the Bible says the eyes of the Lord is upon the righteous to strengthen them. So the Lord's eye is fixed on you. He is jealously watching you to make sure that no evil come near you. Yes, sometimes we go through challenges, and many times some of us go through some challenges, but the Bible says a righteous man or woman go through many challenges, trials, tribulation, persecution, attacks, but the good news is the Lord God Almighty delivered them from them all. In the Psalms, it says that I called upon you in my distress, and the Lord lifted me up from the pit, from deep waters. Sometimes we find ourselves in deep waters, in the very pit of our problems and challenges, and we are so despaired, so discouraged, so feeling hopeless, feeling like giving up, feeling suicidal. But when we cry out to God, he comes in to lift us up, deliver us, redeem us from the pit, from the deep waters. And I pray that this week, the Lord God Almighty will bring you out of every deep pit and deep waters. And may the Lord help you to overcome, give you victory over every situation. I pray for you that the grace of God will see you through today. We'll see you through this moment in your life. We'll see you through whatever challenges. You are made to overcome. You are an overcomer. You are born to win and not a loser. So I declare in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, whatever battle, whatever challenges, whatever issue, crisis you are going through, may you emerge victorious. May you come up on top of every situation. Why? Because the Bible says, greater is he that lives in us than any problem that is coming against us from the world. You are more than an overcomer. You are more than victorious through Christ Jesus. And I see you making it. I see you breaking forth. For the Bible says, I can do all things. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. May the power of God strengthen you. May the grace of God be sufficient for you. May the blood of Christ heal you and deliver you from all evil in the mighty name of Jesus. Join me right now to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus.
Father, we worship you this morning. We worship you this afternoon. We worship you this evening. We give you all the glory, Lord. We glorify you, Lord Jesus. For you alone are worthy. 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 Holy, 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 holy are you, Lord God Almighty. I worship you, Jesus. I glorify you, Jesus. I magnify you, Jesus. I enthrone you, Jesus. You are worthy. Receive all our praise. Receive all our honor. Receive all adoration. We worship you in the beauty of your holiness. There's no God like you, O God. There's no God like you. There's no God before you, beside you, behind you, O Lord. There's none to be compared unto you. There's no God as awesome as you are. You are our kinsman redeemer. You are our strong fortress. You are our rock. You are our fortress. You are our deliverer. You are our shield. You are our strength. You are our refuge. You are our savior. You are the horn of our salvation. You are our stronghold. You are our defender. You are our supporter. You are our redeemer. You are our provider. You are our helper. You are our joy. You are our very reason for living. We bless you, Jesus. I bless you, Jesus. I will adore you, Lord. I adore you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. We glorify you, Jesus. We magnify you, Jesus. I celebrate you, Jesus. I adore you, Jesus. Come and receive all the praise. Be enthroned in our worship today. Be enthroned in our worship today. Be enthroned. We enthroned. Reba Sukataya. We enthroned. Oh, Lord. Receive all the praise. He's worthy to receive all that now. He's worthy to receive all adoration. He's worthy to receive all praise. We worship him in the beauty of his holiness. For his name is Jehovah. He's the almighty, all powerful, all knowing, all wise God. He never makes a mistake. He has the whole world in his hands. He is in perfect control over every situation. And those who put their trust and hopes and confidence in him, he will never fail them or put them to shame. I want you to pray right now and ask the Lord to baptize you, to fill you up with his Holy Spirit and with his power. I want you to pray for grace. I want you to pray for grace. Zechariah 4 verse 6 says, not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit of the living God. The Bible says, those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Jesus says, without me, you can do nothing. You need the Holy Spirit. You need the presence of God. You need the power of God. And when the presence, the power of God is made available, I'm telling you, you can overcome every giant, you overcome every Red Sea, overcome every mountain, overcome every hills, overcome every walls of Jericho, any situation that confronts you, you will overcome, because greater is the power of God, anointing of God, the Holy Spirit in your life. I want you to begin to pray right now that, Lord, baptize me with your Holy Ghost and with your power. Give me supernatural strength. Give me supernatural grace to fulfill your task, your purpose, your assignment for my life. I need your grace. I need your grace. If you are discouraged, if you feel like giving up, if you are despaired, if you are feeling hopeless, or you are faced with any challenge that is beyond your ability to handle, I implore of you, I beg of you to cry out right now and say, Holy Spirit, I hand over, I surrender to you, Holy Spirit. Take over, take over, take over my marriage. Take over my finances. Take over my son, my daughter. Take over my health. Take over the court case. Take over these exams. Holy Spirit, I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. Begin to pray right now. Surrender to the Holy Ghost and let the Holy Spirit begin to do best what he can do best. He does all things and make it possible. Manta laba sukata ya da 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 da. Reba da ba da ba da ba da ba da ba da ba suka ya da ba. Muna ba da ba da ba da brada suka raba shene li buziki tele busata. Reba ba suka raba sakata. We surrender. We surrender. We surrender tonight. We surrender this morning. We surrender this evening. We surrender our cares, our burdens, our needs, our worries, our fears, our challenges. We surrender every issues that we are going through to God right now in prayer. But the Bible says, be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. Holy Spirit, we need you. Spirit of the living God, we need you. Holy Spirit, I need you. I surrender my son. I surrender my wife. I surrender Fresh Fire Ministry. I surrender the members. I surrender everyone connected with us tonight, this morning, this evening, who is desperately in need of your supernatural intervention. Holy Spirit, we surrender. We surrender. Take over. Take charge. Take over. Take charge. Take preeminence. Oh, supernaturally intervene. Holy Ghost, take over. Because you are the God of impossibility. You are the God of wonders. You are the God of miracles. Lord, I need strength, I need grace, I need anointing, I need fresh fire, I need fresh fire. Strengthen me, empower me, and hold me, rebound me, Lord. Rabashite Rebusata, Rebaskuda Bashinde Rebusakataya, Randa Katusi Gidibuka, Rebashinde Rebusakata Rebusuka Brianda, Rambanda Brukutu, Reka Dabrakutu, Reka Dabrukutu, Santa Rabashinde, Rabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabarabar
Reba Shandar Bazekate, Reba Basuka Barabayama, Reba Basuka Barabashin in Musanda, Reba Badada, Ramada, we surrender. Heavenly Father, take over, take control. Be in control over our marriages. Be in control over our children. Be in control over every member of French families.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. Quickly today we are going to be talking about the spirit called Kankawem, the Kankawem spirit. We are still going through restoration. Restoration. Why restoration? Because it's our season of Jubilee. Yesterday we talked about the locust. And anybody who knows locust, they usually come and feed on the leaves and the fruits. The leaves and the fruits. So you see them feeding from the top of the tree. But when we talk about the Kankawem destroys the tree or the harvest from the root, from the ground level. The locust destroys the harvest from the top, whilst the Kankawem destroys the harvest from the bottom. And so that's what we'll be learning in the name of Jesus. Please, can you read for us Joel chapter 2, verse 28?
Joel 2, verse 25. Okay, the 25
talk
about the locust.
Yeah, so I want you to start reading from that point.
Okay, so Joel chapter 2, verse 25. So I will restore to you the years that the swarming locust has eaten, the crawling locust, the consuming locust, and the chewing locust, my great army which I sent among you. Verse 26, you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God, who has dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never be put to shame.
Did your version use Kankawem? Okay, in the other versions, it says, I will restore unto you the years that the locust and the Kankawem has eaten. Today we are talking about the Kankawem. Can you read the Job chapter? Job 2, verse 25.
Job or Joel?
Joel.
Joel 2, verse 25. So I will restore to you the years that the swarming locust has eaten, the crawling locust, the consuming locust, and the chewing locust. They use different types of locust. My great army, which I sent among you, you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God.
Amen. Amen. So Joel chapter 2, verse 25, in other versions, it says, and I will restore to you the years. So when these demons or spirits are destroying, they don't just destroy product, but they destroy years also. I will restore to you the years that the locust have eaten, the Kankawem, the caterpillar, the palmer worm, and my great army, which I sent among you. So here God is talking about, he's going to bring restoration from being devoured or destroyed by the Kankawem. And I said, locust destroy the harvest from the top, or the fruit or the tree from the top, the leaves and fruits, whilst the Kankawem goes to the root from the bottom, it begins to what? Destroy the same harvest. And so we want to learn about the Kankawem and how it operates in our lives. And all you have to do is believe that this is your season whereby the locust, the Kankawem, the caterpillar, and the palmer worm's effect in your life will be destroyed. I will encourage you to know what we are talking about. Some of you are not used to the term Kankawem, caterpillar, palmer worm. So go and Google Kankawem. Go and Google Kankawem and you see the image of the Kankawem, and it will also show you how it destroys the plant. It begins to destroy the plant also from the bottom. So the root, it says, this is a monitoring demon that attacks and destroys people's blessing and destinies from the root level. From the root level. So when a person is going through an attack And it's all beginning with, it stops people from starting anything good in their lives. It does this by putting obstacles in the way of people to block and prevent them from starting their dreams and vision. Whenever you see a person, or whenever you see reoccurring in your life that you find it very, very difficult to initiate or to start project, visions, dreams, aspiration, everything that you want to start, you find it increasingly difficult. It means that the cankam worm spirit or witchcraft or demon is at work in your life. You find it very difficult to start things. You see, there are people who start well but don't finish well. But with what we are talking about, they will not let you even start it. Yes, you said you want to go back to school. So now you said you wish to go back to school. But then this cankam worm will make sure it places obstacles in your path. First, it will make sure you don't have the necessary money to be able to go back to school. And when you dare try to start, it will make sure that it puts obstacles whereby you need to work, you need to pay bills, and therefore you can register for the course, but you have to drop out because you have many other things that will distract you. So you have to pull out of the class. So you can't pursue that class, that course that you know if you had pursued it, it would have increased or your salary or given you a better opportunity. You want to start a business. Cancam Worm will make sure you don't get help from people and loans to even start the business. Cancam Worm will deprive you of help necessary to even start. The starting of a thing is not easy. Cancam Worm will make it difficult to make sure you never start your dreams and vision. And that's what is going on in the lives of many. Many of us start a year with our resolution and begin to say the things that we say we will do. Oh, this year I'm going to lose weight. This year I'm going to go back to school. This year I'm going to change a job or a career. This year I'm going to save this money. But you enter into the year and you realize that all the resolutions and the things you said you'll do, you could never start, because every time you are about to start, something will happen, distract you and derail you. And therefore, when a person is constantly under attack from initiating, they will not give you, they will make sure nobody will help you to start, and they'll make sure that you don't have the resources to start, and they will also make sure that they discourage you from starting, whereby you keep on postponing, procrastinating, being lazy about it, and deferring. Oh, I'll do it tomorrow. I'll do it next week. Tomorrow, because of that, by the time they realize what they said they will do from January up to date, they haven't taken a step of faith to pursue after their dreams and vision. It is the cankam worm. It is attacking you. It doesn't even want the tree or the harvest to grow. It doesn't want to see the tree even grow. It is destroying it from the root. It's destroying it from the root. At least if it grows, it can bear fruit, then locusts can come. But this can come when it's starting, when the seed is planted and it's shooting up and the leaves are just showing up, then this can come when it begins to devour it so that the tree will die. It kills dreams and visions and aspiration. Can come when also can be operating whereby you take in and then you miscarry within the first 4 months, you miscarry the baby. It is an abortive spirit that abort dreams, abort visions, abort destinies, abort anything good that one desires to pursue. It will kill it before you start. And cankam worm spirit can also enter into individuals who you will share your dreams and vision with, that this, I want to start this business. I want to change career so that I can get a better pay. I feel I can go back to school to get this diploma or take this course so that I can do this. And you tell somebody, if the person is being influenced by the cankam worm, immediately you tell them, to tell you can't do it. It's too difficult. I even tried it and failed. This is not meant for you. You are going to waste your time. The person will discourage you and abort that dream that you have concerning that vision or dream. That is a cankerworm agent that the devil has planned in your planted in your life to discourage you from any good development, visions and dreams. Or the cankerworm will also make sure that everyone who promised to help you to start, when it is time for you to start, they all pull back and withdraw their support and withdraw their resources and then leave you bankrupt so much that you can't even start. That is the influence of the cankerworm spirit. People influenced by this demon or witchcraft have difficulty starting anything. Starting anything. They can't start anything. They can't start it. Your problem is starting. If you could only start, you would have finished. If you could only start, you would have excelled. But there are many. So whenever you see people experiencing obstacle, you see, cankerworm will not even allow you to start. So now if the person get a job, they will work so hard and be able to get money and fulfill their dreams. So cankerworm will make sure that you can go to 100 interviews, and cankerworm will make sure that every time you experience rejection and disappointment and denial, and you're not granted that job, because cankerworm will not let you get in. He will not allow your feet to enter, because he knows your potential, he knows your ability, he knows your capability, that if you can only get in, you will excel and fulfill dreams. So cankerworm will make sure that company he enters into, the interviewers or whoever is in charge, to make sure they block you, hinder you, oppose you from even getting in. Oh, cankerworm knows that if only you can get into the course as a nurse, as a doctor, as a lawyer, you will excel. You will apply for the school and they will never pick you up. So every year you will be applying. Or when you get in, cankerworm will make sure they put obstacles. One class will always keep on denying you from moving forward because you are a threat. You are a threat. The reason why cankerworm is attacking you, because it sees your potential, it sees your glory, it sees your ability and virtue, and doesn't want you to manifest the fullness of God's glory upon your life. But today, by revelation, but the Bible says that through knowledge, the righteous will be delivered. I pray and I prophesy and I command every cankerworm spirit that has been hindering you, obstructing you, opposing you, challenging you, inhibiting you, impeding you from executing and starting and initiating the mind and the purpose and the counsel and the prophetic assignment of the Lord for your life, let that cankerworm, demon, witchcraft, power die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. And let that cankerworm cycle that they have put you in be broken in Jesus' name. Be broken in Jesus' name. Be broken in Jesus' name. May the Lord Almighty deliver you totally and completely from this cankerworm spirit that doesn't allow any good thing to be started in your life. So you realize that your problem is everybody is starting something, moving on, but you find it difficult to start. What everybody is able to easily do, you find it difficult. People influenced by this demon find it very difficult to start. Whatever they start, they fail. Whatever they start fails. They never get the help they need to start their visions and dreams. It will cause you to constantly fail. Anytime you start something, you fail. They will not let you move an inch. They will not let you go far because you are too dangerous. Some of us, the reason why we are going through so many battles is because we are so dangerous. We carry great destinies, great potentials, great stars. And the devil says that, make sure you don't allow her to start. Don't even, why can't you even start a marriage, a relationship? Some people have gone through 5 years, 3 years, and not even a man has said, hi, can I take you out? Nobody seems to be coming around them to even, they realize that nobody's interested in them, because the cankerworm doesn't want you to even initiate a relationship, let alone become engaged and marry, because your marriage is beautiful. Your marriage will be glorious, and cankerworm will make sure that it doesn't happen. So he will cause rejection from people. When you see people expressing rejection, cankerworm can be behind the scenes manipulating events so that no the person is not given opportunity. When you are going through Kankam Wem, you are not given opportunity because Kankam Wem sees you as a threat to the demonic establishment. You are too dangerous. If they allow you to start any good thing, they know you will succeed, excel, and make it. Today, I pray any power, any force, any witchcraft, any altar, any mannering spirit, familiar spirit, demonic Kankam Wem demon that is blocking you, hindering you, obstructing you from fulfilling your destiny, let that spirit be consumed by fire, be consumed by fire, Amen. Be consumed by fire, Amen. Be destroyed by fire, Amen. Be consumed by fire, perish by fire of the Holy Ghost. Today, receive your deliverance in the name of Jesus. Say amen.
Amen.
This demon also causes temporal success. The seed is sown, it begins to shoot out, the leaves begin to come out. So everybody's excited. The seed is growing. It has shoot up. Leaves are coming up. It is young, but it is growing. By the time you realize, Kankam Wem start eating it from the ground. And something we were hoping it was going to grow to be a tree for us to harvest, the next day you come, it is dead. Why is it that Kankam Wem have eaten it? Why? So it is called temporal success. Kankam Wem, even when you manage to start, the person starts today only to fail tomorrow. Temporal. Everything that is happening in your life, every good thing that is, has ever happened to you is temporal. It's temporal. You have it today, you lose it tomorrow. You have it today, you lose it tomorrow. You have the job today, you lose it tomorrow. You enter into a relationship today, the next day, the person dump you. Everything you have ever started, anything good that has happened to you is only for temporal. It is only for temporal. Somebody is nice to you today, only to be mean to you tomorrow. Why? Because Kankam Wem will not allow you to experience any permanent success or victories. When you are under the influence of this demon or witchcraft, your testimonies are and breakthroughs are always short-lived. Short-lived. Oh, you will come on. Oh, Reverend K, I thank God. I got a job. I'm so happy. 3 days later, Reverend K, I lost the job. Can't come when. Oh, Reverend K, my husband, he came home after cheating on me and the strange woman was about to snatch it. Thank God, before you could finish, can't come. The man is back again with the other strange woman. Can't come when. Every little breakthrough that you receive, it is short-lived. Testimony is short-lived. Praise reports short-lived. Before you could have said hallelujah, disaster. From breakthrough to breakdown, breakthrough to breakdown, to the point that some people don't know even how to react anymore. Because when they receive any breakthrough, they know that it's not going to go well with them. Later on, something, a tragic thing will happen. Or somebody gets a breakthrough, people are rejoicing, only to realize that the next minute, there's a disaster, a misfortune that has happened to them. See, Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father,
in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
during this season
of jubilee
in my life,
let the spirit, let the demon, let the witchcraft, let the evil cycle
of Kankam Wem be destroyed in Jesus' name. I break myself
loose and free
from the power of Kankam Wem.
In Jesus' name.
You are delivered by this truth. No more will you experience short-lived testimonies, short-lived breakthroughs, temporal success, and always everything that is good comes and short-lived. They prevent permanent or lasting testimonies. Say from today.
My testimony will be permanent.
From today,
my testimony will last
in Jesus' name. You are allowed to break through today only to break down tomorrow. They cause you to laugh today only to be weeping the next day. Anytime you are about to celebrate a victory, they come to scatter your blessing and turn your joy into sorrow. That has been some of Oh, I'm pregnant. I'm pregnant. Hallelujah. After all these years, I'm pregnant. Oh, after 6 months, I lost the baby through miscarriage. What happened? I got a job. I'm so excited. They get in. Few months later, they are fired. What has happened? Can come when. Say, Heavenly Father, deliver me from the spirit of can come when, from the witchcraft of can come when, from the evil cycle of can come when. Break in Jesus' name of my life. Short lived. Happy today, only sad tomorrow. Some of us testimonies we told people about today, we can't defend that testimony because it is no more a testimony because the devil has used the cancan worm to eat it, to devour it. It is no testimony. The thing you were praising God about, the devil has come to steal it again. The marriage you were saying, oh, God has restored my marriage. Today, the man is no more in the house. The job you were so excited about, today, you don't have that same job. The victory you were professing, I have victory over this situation. Today, you are bound. May the Lord Jesus today deliver you from the spirit of cancan worm. Please, these things I'm saying, believe it. I'm not asking you to pray it. Just believe that today is your day of deliverance. Say, this is my day.
This is my
of deliverance.
The power
of the cancan worm
over my life
is broken.
By force.
God was telling me something. Says, son, the evangelical, those who are in Baptist, they don't do much warfare like you guys, you charismatic, but they believe in my word. So they are experiencing some greater levels of breakthrough. You are hearing the word, you are praying, you are fasting, but because you don't believe the power of the word, it's not working. The Bible says, so shall be my word that proceeded out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish the purpose for which I sent it forth. Isaiah 55 verse 11. So there's power. Life is in the word of God. As this word is coming, believe that today the power of cancan worm in my life is broken. Say it's broken.
It's broken.
It is crushed.
It is destroyed.
That spirit of cancan worm, that witchcraft cancan worm,
that demonic
cancan worm,
that
gives me temporal success.
That gives me temporal
and causes me to weep whenever I have to celebrate. That spirit is destroyed.
That spirit is accursed
in Jesus' name.
And the cycle is broken off my life.
It is my season of jubilee. And I'm being restored. From the cancan worm demon. In Jesus' name. Believe the word. Some of you, I don't know what to say to you anymore. You don't believe in nothing. So you are coming on and you are not receiving any breakthrough because you've chosen not to walk by faith. It is faith. You believe. I believe that today, cancan worm, you are over. You can't stop me anymore. I will start. I'll get the help. I'll get the resources. This new blessing will be permanent. And it will not be stolen by the cancan worm anymore. I will not experience a temporal blessings anymore because its power over me is broken. You believe. It is faith. Faith overcomes all things. You don't have faith. You can scream, you can pray, you can jerk, you can vomit. If you don't have faith, nothing works. Believe in Jesus' name. Anytime you are about to celebrate a victory, they come to scatter your blessing and turn your joy into sorrow. They block you from having a permanent divine helpers. So every time you need the help to push you to the next level, you realize that there's no one to help you. The Bible says that there was a man who was at the pool of Bethesda for about 38 bad years. The only reason he could not get himself healed and delivered from his affliction and oppression is because he had no one to help him to put him in the water. And when you don't have help, you are going to be delayed. You are going to be denied. You are going to be late in life. And some of us can come when we make sure that the help that you need, they don't give it to you so that your life will be wasted. Today, I pray that spirit of cancan worm that is blocking permanent helpers from locating you, let that spirit die. Let that spirit die. Amen. Let that witch die. Amen. Let that wizard die. Amen. Let that altar perish. Amen. Let that familiar spirit perish. Let that monitoring spirit perish from your life in the name of Jesus. Today, you shall receive permanent help, permanent blessings, permanent victories, permanent joy in the Lord, because it is our season of Jubilee. I declare jubilee over your life in Jesus' name. They deny you the help you need to fulfill your dreams and visions. When the demon of cankerworm is operating against you, people are nice to you today only to hate you tomorrow. People are nice to you. People are nice to you today. How are you doing? I like you. I'll help you out. Only to hate you the next day. Why? Because of cankerworm will cause rejection and disappointment. When opportunities open up to you today, they are closed the next day. Oh, come for the interview. You go for the interview. It is okay. We like you. We think we will give you the job. The next day, you said they tell you hear from them. 3 months, 6 months, you've never heard. You call them, they give you stories. They are not interested in you anymore. Opportunities that come to you to enter, this cankerworm will shut every opportunity to your life. Opportunities to marriage. A woman recently was engaged by a man so excited. The man even bought her the ring and everything is set. By the time she realized, the man has just disappeared. Nowhere to be found. Left her in limbo. Where is the man? Nowhere. Marriage, wedding, everything called off. Cankerworm will cause your joy to turn into sadness. Every opportunity, job opportunity, career opportunity, destiny opportunity, cankerworm will keep on shutting the door. Only you, people are entering into open doors. People are entering. When it is your turn to enter, then it is shut, slammed shut before you. Today, any cankerworm spirit that has been slammed shutting destiny doors to you, let that demon, let that witch, let that evil spirit, let that satanic spirit that is fighting your destiny, die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. I curse that spirit out of your life. I bind and cast that spirit out of your life. And I pray that from today, no more will you miss your divine appointment, your divine visitation, and your divine opportunities again. You will not miss it. You will not lose it in the name of Jesus. Let doors of opportunities open to you in the mighty name of Jesus. I prophesy, I declare, I decree, I command it to be so in your life in Jesus' name. People promise to help you today only to change their mind the next day. This is because of the evil influence of the cankerworm spirit. I want you to be angry. I want you to be angry. We are praying only two prayer points. The time is up. You are going to pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, any cankerworm spirit that is fighting my life, let that spirit die. Let that spirit die. Let that spirit die. Let that spirit die. In the name of Jesus, any cankerworm demon, any cankerworm spirit that is fighting my destiny, let that spirit die. Let that spirit perish. Any cankerworm demon, any cankerworm witchcraft, any cankerworm demon, any cankerworm witchcraft that is working against me, that is causing me not to get opportunities, that is causing me not to start my destiny and my breakthrough, that is causing short-lived blessings and breakthroughs, that is causing me to miss my opportunities, any cankerworm demon that is fighting my destiny, fighting my life, fighting my marriage, fighting my finances, fighting my education, fighting me in destiny, every cankerworm spirit, any cankerworm demon, any cankerworm altar, any cankerworm witchcraft, I command you to die in the mighty name of Jesus. I command you to die. It is my season of jubilee. I command you to die. Begin to pray that prayer seriously and aggressively.
Every cankerworm demon, I command you to die. 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 Every cankerworm against my son, against my wife, against my children, against my family, against our members, against our followers, against our viewers. Every cankerworm in your life, I curse that spirit to die. To will die by fire, die by thunder, die by fire. Every monetary spirit that monitors your life, that causes a temporal success, that causes temporal joy in your life, that has been blocking, hindering, obstructing you from moving forward in life. I cast that demon, I cast that witchcraft, I cast that force to die by fire, die by thunder, die by fire, die by thunder, die by fire, die by thunder. I command the spirit of cankerworm to perish, 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 perish from my life. Die, die from my life. I bind you and cast you out of my life. Your assignment over my life is broken. In the name of Jesus, you're going to pray. The next prayer, in the name of Jesus, I command the spirit of cankerworm, the cycle of cankerworm, the evil cycle of disappointment, the evil cycle of not able to start, the evil cycle of always turning your happiness into sorrow, the evil cycle of always obstructing you, blocking you, hindering you from starting your dreams and destiny, the evil cycle of procrastination and deferring and delaying everything in your life, the evil cycle of denying you of divine helpers, the evil cycle that causes temporal success, temporal dreams, visions, everything about you is temporal, never permanent, because you get it today and you lose it tomorrow. Let the evil cycle of the cankerworm in my life break today in the name of Jesus. Let the evil cycle, let the evil cycle, let the evil cycle of the cankerworm in my life, in my marriage, in my finances, in my job, in my health, in my destiny, let the evil cycle of the cankerworm be broken in the name of Jesus. Be broken in the name of Jesus. Begin to break that evil cycle. Evil cycle of rejection, evil cycle of delay, evil cycle of stagnation, evil cycle of hindrances, obstacles, roadblocks, lack of help and funds and divine helpers because of the cankerworm. In the name of Jesus, I command the evil cycle of the cankerworm against my life, against my wife, against Fresh Fire Ministry and the members. Let it be broken, let it be destroyed. I break the curse of the cankerworm. I break the curse of the cankerworm of your life, of your family, of your children, of your finances, of your destiny, in the name of Jesus. Let the power of the cankerworm in your life break in Jesus' name. 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 Every cankerworm witchcraft, every cankerworm sorcery, every cankerworm curse, every cankerworm altars, every cankerworm agent, powers operating, influencing my life and destiny, my children, my destiny, my ministry, Lord God Almighty, the destinies of Fresh Fire Ministry members, break in Jesus' name. Break in Jesus' name. Break in Jesus' name. Break in Jesus' name. We break the evil cycle. We break the evil party. We break the evil trainer. We break the evil track in the name of Jesus. We break evil cycles of the cankerworm in the name of Jesus. Joel chapter 2, verse 25. I will restore. I will restore. I will restore the years that the locusts have eaten and the cankerworm. God says he will restore. I don't know about you. Please, these prayers are all about faith. This week, it is about faith. You must come to the place whereby you said, enough is enough. Lord, enough is enough. I have heard your word and you are bringing deliverance to me. That's why I've gotten this revelation. So today, Lord, restore me. Restore me. Whatever the cankerworm has eaten in my life, whatever the cankerworm has eaten in my marriage, whatever the cankerworm has eaten in my finances, whatever the cankerworm has eaten in my ministry, whatever the cankerworm has eaten in my dreams and vision, Father, restore. Lord, restore. Restore by fire. Restore by thunder. Restore, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let there be a restoration. Whatever the cankerworm have eaten and destroyed and devoured in my life, Lord, restore it, Lord. Lord, restore it, Lord. Lord, restore it into me, unto me, in the name of Jesus. Begin to pray for restoration. Restoration, 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 restoration of soul, restoration of destiny, restoration of my body, soul, my destiny, my calling, restoration, restore, 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 restoration, 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 restore, oh God, my destiny, restore, oh God, my glory, restore, oh Lord, my star, my virtue, restore, oh Lord, my honor, restore, oh Lord, my reputation, restore, oh Lord, my blessings, my prosperity, my riches, my treasures, restore, oh Lord, my strength, my joy, my peace, my favors, restore, restore, my divine helpers, restore, opportunities, restoration, restoration, in the name of Jesus, restoration, in the name of Jesus, through the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, restoration, restoration, by the power of the Holy Ghost, whatever that can come with, has eaten, we command total restoration, right now, total restoration, in our marriages, in our family, in our finances, in our health, we command total, complete, all-round restoration in the name of Jesus. Father, restore my life in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You better believe. You better believe. These are prayers you pray of faith. These are prayers of faith to deal with warfare. And it works. It works for those who believe. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you. May the cycle of the cankerworm in your life be broken. And may the power of the cankerworm demon or witchcraft be crushed, be consumed by fire. In the name of Jesus, today, be delivered from the evil cycle of the cankerworm. And may the God of restoration, by the blood, restore you in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's take our communion. Let's take our communion. Take our communion. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. You're going to take the blood and say this after me. Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
This is my season.
This is my season.
Of Jubilee.
Of Jubilee.
Your word says.
Your word says.
The kingdom of God.
That the kingdom of
suffered God violence.
Suffered violence.
And the violence.
And the violence.
Take it by force.
Take it by force.
I am taking.
I am taking.
I am taking.
I am taking.
My blessings.
My blessings.
My prosperity.
My prosperity.
My opportunities.
My opportunities.
My glory.
My glory.
My star.
My star.
My virtue.
My virtue.
My honor.
My honor.
My breakthroughs.
My breakthroughs.
Every blessing,
every blessing
that you have for me,
have
I am taking it by force in the name of Jesus.
In the name of
Heavenly
Jesus.
Father,
Heavenly
by this revelation, whatever the cankerworm have eaten, devoured, blocked, hindered
in my life,
let it be restored.
Let it be restored.
Triple restoration.
Triple restoration.
Triple for my troubles.
Triple for my
in the name of Jesus.
In the name
let
of Jesus.
The power,
let the power
of the cankerworm
over my life
be crushed
by the blood of Jesus.
Let the cycle.
Let the cycle
of the cankerworm
in my
life
be broken
by the blood of Jesus.
Blood of
as I drink the blood, in the name of Jesus,
restore
unto me every blessing
that
has been devoured
by the cankerworm.
Restore me, Lord.
Restore
in
me,
Jesus' name I pray.
In Jesus' name I pray.
Before you drink, whatever the Bible says, the life of a person is in the blood. There's power in the blood of Jesus. I want you to speak to the blood of Christ. The Bible says the blood of Christ speaks better things. Blood of Jesus, restore my health. Blood of Jesus, restore my body. Blood of Jesus, restore my finances. Talk to the blood and ask the blood the specific thing you want it to restore in your life and then drink it in the name of Jesus. I'm giving you a time to pray right now. Talk to the blood. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen and amen. The fasting continues from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. We are fasting for 21 days. Today is the ninth day. I think today is the ninth day of our fasting and prayer.
Join us tomorrow from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. We are fasting. We break the fasting at 6 p.m. and we meet at 11 p.m. Eastern Time U.S. 11 p.m. Eastern Time U.S., 4 a.m. London, 5 a.m. Europe, and we meet on YouTube, this broadcast, wherever you are watching. It's the Fresh Fire Prayer Line YouTube, Fresh Fire Prayer Line, or KL Blessing, or Facebook is KL Blessing. Go to our website for more information, www.freshfireprayer.com, www.freshfireprayer.com, www.freshfireprayer.com. Those who sent your sacrifice and Jubilee sacrifice through Cash App or Zelle, just send me an email, and then I have prayers I'll send to you. So just make sure you send me your email. Some of you have already sent the prayers to you, and I'm praying for you that the Lord will deal with the hidden curses and covenant and the Jubilee blessing. Some of you sent your money through Zelle and Cash App. If you haven't, email me and tell me about and say the prayers for the seed. Either the, how do you call it, the hidden curses or the Jubilee, and then we will send it to you. Some of you too, you use the PayPal, but your email didn't show up. So it's possible you have sent through PayPal, but still you haven't received it. Send me from your own email. You'll get my email on our website, www.freshfireprayer.com. Go to contact, and you can send, you can get information from there. And you can send your sacrifice of the Jubilee and also the hidden curses on our website, www.freshfireprayer.com. If it's Cash App, it's Fresh Fire Prayer. Zelle and the other mediums are also on, how do you call it, on our website. And if you sent in through the mail, some of you sent checks through the mail, please also send me an email. I will forward you the prayers of agreement that whatever you are believing God for, may the Lord remember you and grant it to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Go to our website and you can get an email and send me an email, and we'll keep on sending you the prayers and stand with you until God's purposes are established. www.freshfireprayer.com, www.freshfireprayer.com, and subscribe to our YouTube and Facebook channel, Fresh Fire Prayer Line. All those of you watching us from there, Fresh Fire Prayer Line, please, when you are done, just go ahead and subscribe to that channel and hit the bell. And also, if you are watching from the KL Blessing, subscribe to it. And if you're on Facebook, click on the follow to also connect. God richly bless you. Tomorrow, our scripture reading is Romans chapter 15. We are reading Romans chapter 15 tomorrow. Romans chapter 15 tomorrow. And the fasting continues. May the Lord God Almighty prosper, bless, and restore. We are in our season of Jubilee. So keep on believing God for total, complete blessings and restoration. And it shall come to pass in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless you all. Bye.
You are all that matters.
You are all that matters. Oh, hey, oh, you are all that matters. Oh, hey, oh, hey, you are all that matters. Oh, hey, oh, hey, you are all that matters. Oh, hey, oh. Ana no kanya man,
what would I be for if I don't have you?
If I don't have you, Lord,
what would I be if you take the Holy Ghost?